Good morning, all. Once again, welcome to Tuesday Bible Talk Devotional. I want to thank you once again for joining us at St. Paul Missionary Baptist Church, and I want to say happy Black History Month. We are entering the month, we've just entered the month, where we celebrate our culture, we celebrate our achievements, we celebrate who we are. Now, I don't think that's a month thing. I think that's an everyday thing. As the children of God and God's special called out people, we should celebrate what God has done in our lives all the time. But that's a talk for a different time. Today, we're gonna talk about what God has put on my heart to share with you, and I pray that it blesses you in some way, shape, or form. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for another wonderful day you have made. Father, just in the last few months, we've seen you just inch us closer and closer to same, to care, to empathy, to love. But Father, if we had turned to you first, we never would have left that place. We thank you, Father, that you're patient with us, you're loving with us, you're forgiving to us. You give us time to grow and to come to realizations that are right in front of us. We bless you, Father. We bless you with our lives. This is in Jesus' name that I pray and I thank you. Amen, Father. Well, today, to that point, I have a very simple scripture, but a scripture I care dearly about. Good morning, Aunt Celia. Good morning, Pastor. And it comes from Matthew 16, 13 through 18. And that's the English Standard Version. Now, when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, others say Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say I am?" Simon Peter replied, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but by my Father who is heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." And it brings me to a question I ask myself, and I'll ask you now. Who do you say Jesus is? And can the church, his church, grow on your testimony of him? Does your life give a living testimony to your faith in Christ? Do you let your light so shine before men that people see your godly works and glorify your God in heaven? And that's what Matthew 5 and 16 ask us. To go back to that main scripture, let's just understand that Jesus wasn't talking about he was going to build his church on the man Peter. He was saying his church would be built on that testimony, that realization of who he was. Peter's faith and confession that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, these are the tenets that the church was and is continually being built upon. If we have not, and you know, many Christians, we all come in different ways and fashion, but if we haven't come to that realization, if we haven't gone back to the basics, if we haven't grasped who Jesus is, and we haven't confessed it with our mouths, we haven't believed it in our hearts. And I'm not putting anybody down, but I want you to understand, many of us came because mama or grandmama or mom and dad or uncle or somebody brought us to church. And that's where we still are. We're just coming to church. And we know all the stuff, but we haven't stopped and confessed with our mouths and believed in our hearts that Jesus Christ is Lord and that he died for us. You know, we know those things, but we haven't come to that realization. So sometimes we just got to put the brakes on and stop and say, before I go any further on this journey towards eternity, I need to stop and ask myself, is that true? Have I done the groundwork? Have I done the basics? You know, I do all the other stuff, but I've never really thought about that. I took it for granted because the church is so welcoming. It's so warm. It opened its arms. It just let me in, and I was here. And I just said, well, I'm just like everybody else. And I guess I believe. I guess I know. I've heard it. But have you investigated? Have you looked inside yourself and say, do I have that testimony? If it was me standing here by myself with Christ, say, I will build my church on your testimony. Make the answer yes. This is the time for self-reflection and to get inside yourself and find out, is that really true as you take this march towards eternity? Because that's our destination. That's what we're aiming for. You know, let's stop and take a realistic look at our relationship with the Father through Christ, because it is by faith in Christ that we are saved. It is by faith in Christ that we are made whole. It's by faith in Christ that we are promised eternal life. By faith in Christ, we can do all things. I mean, I can go on and on and on. The promises are there. They are true. Let's just reconnect. It is by faith in him. Believing in your heart, confessing with your mouth. So the faith, both internally and outwardly in confession, we've got to get to that basic place. So again, I'll ask you, who do you say Jesus is? Is your life a living testimony that he is the Christ, the Son of the living God? You know, right now is such a perfect time because there are no sanctuaries to sit in the mist and kind of hide where your attendance is your testimony of your faithfulness. It's just taken for granted. There is no sanctuary to do that in. There are no committees, no boards, no choir, not even pulpits to blend in and hide the true nature of your faith or the lack of. So this is the time we turn inward and we glow outward. When we investigate our inward, there ought to be something, some signs, some things happening that show that that confession is true, that that faith is true, that our walk is true, that everybody can see. Your light so shines that the world sees it. You know, if your light's been shining, but you've had a lampshade over it because you kind of get lost in the muddle of corporate worship, well, this is the time to pull that lampshade off and let your light shine. Go about the business of being who God wants you to be in faith, to show your faith through your works. Galatians 3:26 says that we are all children of God by faith in Jesus Christ. This thing, and I'll use that for lack of a word, that we're called to be the ecclesia, the church, the gathering of the called out ones that are led by the Holy Spirit. It rests on our testimony that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. See, it just keeps coming back. It's not about all the extemporaneous stuff. All that stuff is wonderful. They're the showings of our faith. But we got to get back to the basics and get on our faith. Just as in this scripture, It says this won't be revealed by man. The Father will reveal it to you. So if God has revealed the truth to you, as he did to Peter, then also the gates of hell will not prevail. You know, Peter had some trials in his walk with Jesus. You know, once Jesus said, "Get thee behind me, Satan," because Peter was like, nope, you're not going to be crucified. That's not going to happen. That was the will of God. Peter was trying to stand in the way. Okay? Peter denied him. Not once, not twice, but three times. Peter, in Christ's defense, when he was going to the crucifixion, when he was about to be arrested, Peter cut off a man's ear. And Christ had to say, "Whoa, back up." That's why he was that rock. He was stern. He was hard in his conviction. Sometimes he jumped out in front of the Lord, and the Lord had to slow him up. So I'm saying all that to say that might be you. I can certainly see tenets of that and some semblances of that in me. Sometimes I just get I believe what I believe, and I move the way I move. And sometimes I'm unshakable about that. And God, I think I'm unshakable because God shakes it out real quick. But sometimes you're going to mess up. Sometimes you're going to do things that might not be in agreement with the will and the way of God. But see, it's your motivation. It's your faith. It's your heart. It's your love for God that God is judging, because he already knows you're an imperfect person. You were born into sin and inequity. So he's covered for that by the blood of Jesus Christ. So just move in faith and make sure your motivations are in line with what God wants you to do, because the gates of hell will not prevail over Christ establishing his church, but he wants to establish it through you and me and Ron Jackson and Jackie Slaughter Gibbons and Celia Bynes and Georgia Carter and Clayton E. Taylor Jr. and Clayton E. Taylor Sr. I'm sorry, I'm just reading the names I can see. But he wants to establish it through us, his church, his called out, the people led by his Holy Spirit. But we've got to go back to that place where he took Peter. "Who do you say I am?" Well, he asked all the disciples, just one spoke up. "Who do you say I am? And if you say you are the Son of the living God, you are the Christ, then you're foundationally in the right place. But you got to believe that in your heart and confess that with your mouth. And we can move forward." You know, just as the resurrected Christ exhorted Peter, this man, with those oops factors in his walk with Christ. But Christ, after the resurrection, he pulled Peter to the side. And three times, just like the three denials, he said, "Feed my sheep. Feed my sheep. Feed my sheep." Well, I submit to you today, God, the resurrected Christ who walks with us, is saying to us to feed his sheep. Spiritually, his ecclesia, his set apart people, we ought to be feeding each other. Feeding each other the love of God. Feeding each other compassion. Feeding each other with the fruit of the Spirit. Letting our lives be a living testimony to one another and to the world that Jesus Christ is Lord. And because we follow him, we're different. See, we can't talk the way the world talks. We can't walk the way the world walks. We can't treat people the way the rest of the world treats people. We're different. We're called out. We're set apart. Let's be different. Let's be different. Our lives matter. Christian lives matter to God. I know we're on some crusades, but let's say Christian lives matter, and they matter to God. So let's make them matter to the rest of the world. Let our light so shine. I mean, bling bling, Oh, my goodness. Look at the shine coming off that Spirit of God. Let's be that. Let's be that. But as we get there, let's hold true to that testimony. And if you got a brother or sister, a friend, a mentor, anyone in your life, and you know they need your help, help them in this walk. Help them get to that place where they can sit down and truly confess. They can confess that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. He is our Savior. He is our everything. That's my little message for the day. I know it was kind of simple. But see, sometimes it's the simplicity that we overlook. We get to the high level thing, but we forget the foundations. And the foundations of this whole thing is that we have to believe in our hearts and confess with our mouths that Jesus Christ is Lord. And we have to walk in that glory. All right? Hey, once again, I want to tell you folks, I love you. Let's celebrate Black History Month by making Black history this month, by being something so special that God will stand up and give us a hand. Amen. Love you guys. Y'all take care.